show you the steps to complete a payment slip in Excel. So here we have our employee name, which is Barney Rubble, our employee number, which is 235, and then we have our salary. Let's say he's on a monthly salary of $3,000 a month. And so what I've done is I've, below his monthly salary, I've put his deductions. So we have federal tax, and the federal tax, this is just numbers out of my head, is the value times 13%, and the provincial tax is times 9%. Unemployment insurance is times 3%, and Canadian pension plan is times 5%. Now, what I did to get the total, which is his net pay, is I've taken C8, which is his total salary, and I've subtracted all of these deductions, and that equals his net pay. And the payment date is there, and so it would probably be deposited in his bank, which is Royal Bank, and then the account number is this. Now, this is really easy, but I have linked it also to a sheet so you can see who you've paid what each month. Now, so each of these are linked back to the Barney sheet and the C8. Now, chances are, if September runs around and you had to pay Barney again and he's still on the same salary, what you could just do is copy this complete sheet, change the dates, and then you're ready to go for the next month. The other thing about this is that it's all linked. So if Barney argues that I've forgotten his increase in pay, so he's now making $3,300 here. So everything is linked, and so now his net pay, the deductions are all changed, and his net pay is changed to $2,310. And once again, on his on the roster here, the net pay has changed to $2,310. The rest of this thing is just formatting. I just removed the grid lines by going to the View tab, and here I am. And then I just highlighted and filled in some things just to make it look nice. So that's how you make a payment slip in Excel. Please subscribe.